Hello, in this video I want to follow up on a previous video I made where I installed some SSD cache in a Synology DS918 Plus NAS. And I did some sort of kind of benchmarks to try and see if there was any speed gain, and I didn't get results that showed that I was getting any significant speed gain with the system. So people left me some comments on there which were pretty helpful. And I think the reason is that I'm accessing the NAS over a gigabit Ethernet, and the theoretical top speed of gigabit Ethernet is 125 megabytes per second, and I was getting 80 megabytes per second. And I think that's just the top speed of my network, because you won't really get to the theoretical top speed of it. So I think that was the speed. My top speed, I think, was maxing out my network. So I've come up with some other tests to kind of show the cache working. So I'll look at that. Now, I'm going to be accessing the NAS using SSH. So if you're not familiar with that, how to get to that, if you go to the control panel and click advanced mode, you'll see this terminal and SNMP. If you open that up, you can enable SSH service on your NAS device. And this, I'm not going to go through how to use SSH, but you know, if you have questions, you can leave them in the comments, but you can Google how to do that. But I'm in a terminal, and I've gotten into the Synology NAS here, and I've created a folder, and I'm going to create a file, and this will kind of test the write speed. So I'll say dd in file equals dev 0. So I'm going to be pulling from this device that just creates zeros on a server. This is on pretty much any Unix system. And I'll say out file equals temp.txt. I'll say bs or byte size equals 1 meg. And I'll say count equals 100. So this will create approximately like 100 megabyte file. So I'll run this, and we'll see that copied to the drive in 1.1 gigabytes per second. So that would indicate to me that the cache is working, the write cache, because the spinny hard drives I don't think would run that fast. So now we can read that back. We can say dd in file equals temp out file equals dev null, and that's kind of a bottomless pit that you can say copy things into, but it's extremely fast because you're not actually copying to any drive. So we'll run this, and we'll see it says 639 megabytes per second, and run again, it says 650 megabytes per second. So that is also would make me think it's using SSD. So now I'm going to find a file on the server I have not accessed. So I'm going to find that. I'll jump cut the video after I find that, and we'll do some testing with it. Okay, so I looked through my hard drive, and I found an ISO for FreeNAS, which I thought would be funny to do. So I have here, I've selected I think it's around a 600 megabyte file, and I'm reading that in, and I'm outputting it to dev null. So I will run this, and this should be pulling from the regular hard drives. So we see here that we had a read speed of 219 megabytes per second. So if this loaded into the cache and we run it again, we should see a higher speed, which we did, 566 megabytes per second. And I don't think running it again would speed it up slightly. I don't know. That's probably not a huge deal. So this seems to tell me that the cache is working. So this was probably the speed, you know, from the hard drives, and this would be the speeds from the SSD here. So what this is showing me is that these SSDs likely won't speed up my network access Although for like random reads, it could, maybe that could help. It's hard to say how that would all work out, but I think a big advantage of these would be for using virtualization on it, which I am using some virtualization. I plan to use more because that's accessing everything locally within the machine. So when you're using virtualization, you are limited by the hard drive speed. Having these caches on there should speed everything up. So this is just a quick, simple test I kind of came up with because I wanted to have some numbers that showed that the cache was actually doing something. But certainly, if you have any comments or questions, leave them below. I'd really like reading what people's thoughts are on all this. Or if you have any specific benchmarks you want me to run, I could probably try those. I don't plan on removing the cache to try these tests without the cache in. That's kind of a hassle. But I don't think I would have gotten numbers like this, if it wasn't doing some sort of caching. So, but if you disagree with me, leave a comment below and we'll talk about it. So I appreciate everyone watching, and I'll put a link below to my playlist so you can watch my other videos. And thanks for watching.